When playing Yahtzee, you roll 5 regular 6-sided dice. How many different outcomes are possible from a single roll? The order of the dice does not matter. We will answer this question using the stars and bars method of counting. To begin, because we have 5 identical dice or 5 indistinguishable dice, we have 5 stars. And because there are 6 distinguishable outcomes or 6 possible outcomes per die, we have 5 bars. The number of bars is always 1 less than the number of distinguishable outcomes or distinguishable items. And this is because if we have 6 outcomes, we would have to have 5 switches to switch from the first outcome to the 6th outcome. From here, every string we can form of length 10 with 5 stars and 5 bars represents 1 possible outcome when rolling 5 regular 6-sided dice in the game of Yahtzee when the order of the dice doesn't matter. Let's take a look at 3 possible stars and bars charts. For the first chart, we start with a star, which indicates we assign the first outcome of 1 to, let's just say, the first die. And then we have 2 bars, which represents 2 switches, and therefore we switch from 1 to 2 and then 2 to 3. And then we have another star, and therefore 3 becomes the outcome of the second die. We have another bar, and therefore we switch from the outcome of 3 to the outcome of 4. And then we have 2 stars, 4 becomes the outcome for the third and fourth dice. And then we have 2 more bars, which means we switch from 4 to 5 and then 5 to 6. And then we have 1 more star, 6 becomes the outcome of the fifth die. Now remember, the order here doesn't matter. The outcome is 1, 1, 1, 3, 2 fours, and a 6. Looking at the second chart, we start with a bar, which indicates we switch from 1 to 2, and then we have 2 stars, which indicates 2 becomes the outcome of the first and second dice. Next, we have 3 bars, which represents 3 switches. We switch from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and then 4 to 5. And then we have 3 stars. 5 becomes the outcome of the third, fourth, and fifth dice. And then we have a bar, which represents switching from 5 to 6, but there are no more stars, and therefore we're done. The outcome is 2 twos and 3 fives, which is called a full house in Yahtzee. And then finally, for the next chart, we start with 3 bars, which indicates 3 switches. We switch from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 4. Then we have 5 stars, which means 4 is the outcome for all 5 dice. And then we have 2 bars, which represents switching from 4 to 5 and 5 to 6. But again, there are no more stars, and therefore we're done. And this outcome is called Yahtzee when we have 5 of the same outcomes. So again, the number of strings we can form with 5 stars and 5 bars is equal to the number of possible outcomes when rolling 5 regular 6-sided dice in the game of Yahtzee. And the number of ways is equal to 10 choose 5. We form the combination by summing the stars and bars and choosing the number of bars. This shouldn't be surprising. If we think about bit strings, and we think of the stars as zeros and the bars as ones, the number of bit strings of length 10 with 5 ones or a weight to 5 is 10 choose 5. And 10 choose 5 is equal to 10 factorial divided by the product of 10 minus 5 factorial and 5 factorial. Let's go ahead and simplify by hand. 10 factorial is equal to 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 factorial. Notice in the denominator we have 2 5 factorials. Let's expand one of them. 5 factorial is equal to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And we have times another 5 factorial. And now simplifying, 5 factorial divided by itself simplifies to 1. In the denominator, we have 3 times 2, which is 6. 6 divided by 6 simplifies to 1. 4 and 8 share a common factor of 4. There's 1, 4, and 4, and 2, 4s, and 8. 5 and 10 share a common factor of 5. There's 1, 5, and 5, and 2, 5s, and 10. We're left with 2 times 9 times 2 times 7, which is equal to 252. There are 252 possible outcomes when rolling 5 regular 6-sided dice in the game of Yahtzee when the order of the dice doesn't matter. I hope you found this helpful.